It's not T-Rex Reaper Maynard!
Oh my god, we did it.
I mean, for me, it's already a victory.
I mean, we have to still cast the game in pre-professional here, but I kind of want to hug Wardy and cry to his shoulder with just happy tears. But we do have a medevac very quickly from TY, an aggressive follow-up.
I kind of like it. You know, your reactor and Hellions, you know your opponent's kind of messed up a little bit early, and maybe it's an opportunity to deal some damage. So I like it. It feels like it gives you a good option, something to mix up. I mean, there's so many different ways to open up in TVT and then end up at the same endpoint of moving into your bio play or your mech play. A fast cyclone from Cure and actually from TY as well, but it's a distraction technique because look what this in the main TY for Hellions, and the cyclone gets there but a bit too late. This is going to be some SCV kills.
Absolutely, and it looks pretty blinder here. A lot of damage going down. 6 SCVs of Cure. Looks like it might potentially be 8 in the end there. Just one more shot. Yes, 8 is going to be the tally, and the medevac actually gets out of dodge as well as the cyclone locked on to the Hellions and not to the medevac. So you really had to prioritize killing those units.
Keeping that third base building, and we'll take that slight advantage. TY kind of needed to do maybe a little bit more. I mean, it's so even, right? 43 to 42. Army supply is pretty even as well. He's just TY a little behind on that army. But honestly, nothing too crazy. As engineering base come up, racks come up. We are seeing bio out of Cure. Now, TY is on 4 gases and hasn't dropped production yet. And the longer you wait for that, the more likely it can be to be mech. It's not this time. It is engineering base and barracks. But as each second passes by, it's like, oh my god, if you don't start producing Marines now or Stimpak now, you're so behind in this game.
Yeah, you just can't be on 1-1-1 forever, that's for damn sure. Raven popping up into the main base, does have enough for a single auto turret, gonna do it again here. Meanwhile, TY moving through the middle of the map, trying to poke up that high ground and Cure and find an angle. More denied mining time, more SCV damage, nice move from Cure.
As right now, they're both just building up though, the second factory, so important to keep that siege tank production up and rolling also.
TY moving out here because this clearly is where he wants to take his fourth. Cure sending out that first Marine. Having a poke at the defenses of TY, sees just one tank and one cyclone, but always more where that came from. He scans that ramp. Here comes TY's defenses. Our first real fight in the game kicking in here with Cure getting the tank on the front line, then pulling back.
Yeah, he doesn't want to overcommit. He saw the rest of the siege tanks, right? And there's a good amount of Marines there as well, so he backs away. But even just picking off a siege tank here and a siege tank there, it's less that TY can use to defend as this game continues onwards. So again, it's all about Cure so far, right?
TY getting his extra star ports as well here, and Cure, I don't know if he's going for Liberators here, Wardy. He's starting more Tech Labs. This might actually just be BCs.
You think just straight up BCs? It is what Tech Labs are kind of for, right? Yeah, maybe just go straight at Battlecruisers here. I mean, if he feels he's that far ahead, maybe. He's starting 3 more command centers too, so Cure is already saying, yeah, I'm not committing to a larger fight. I'm not trading out. I'm building up to take base after base. I'm building up to have so many mules. I can scan you all the time. And for Cure, he's really just setting up ready for late game. And I get the feeling that TY is going to follow him, right? I mean, starting to expand towards a fifth base already. We actually see Corvid Reactor, so maybe even just a couple of Ravens initially.
I mean, Ravens are still fantastic at any moment in TVT. They do lock down tanks, and even when you get to the later stage of the game, they can also be used for anti-armor missile, and even locking down BCs if TY gets any even more later, but that is far ahead. We do have a little bit of scuffle here with TY, fading out a bit of a stim there, not really able to achieve too much with it. It's a bit of energy wasted, but he is pushing forward here, and this is something that TY likes to do when he pushes, getting a bit of static defense around his units, some turrets going down, sensor towers as well.
Down. And behind all of that, even the simple things like stimming your Marines is an extra task involved. Wow, it's crazy watching them control this so far. It's only going to get crazier. Viking BC on the way up, they both seem pretty even across the board. Biggest difference is just slightly later ship weapons here from Cure. But I'd even argue maybe that he's had the slightly faster kind of movement in towards Vikings and BCs, so maybe that just offsets it a little bit. As we do see an attempt from TY to get in position on the right, but it doesn't look like that's going anywhere.
Trying to deny this base of Cure on the left as well with the BCs. His Vikings tussling with the Ravens. Much superior Raven count here for Cure. TY, I think, had one Raven that he's actually lost. He's decided right now to use 2 Tech Lab starports to replenish those numbers. His BCs basically on a drive-by here, going through the SCV line of Cure. Going to kill quite a few of them as well as Cure's army's out of position. And can always tactical jump away when those Marines get under there.
These BCs are fantastic harassing units. They're going to be able to do so much when it comes down to harassing bases that just don't have proper defenses set up. And when you've got every base on your half of the map, you can't be everywhere, and the BCs are so mobile with that jump as well. It's gonna be a jump in. The BCs from Cure will then jump out. It looks as though Cure gets away.
And that command center of TY nearly canceled there. Of course, not a massive investment. He does have 3,000 in the bank right now. Cure just spent a lot of his minerals. You know, the bank's kind of switched on their head here with TY now a lot richer than Cure. And again, like, these Ravens are going to be fantastic when he actually commits to a massive engagement, especially against the BCs, as they're a big, easy target to get interference matrices on. but they are just not a great fighting unit anymore at this particular phase of the game. He's still throwing in, or rather TY is throwing in more. Still gonna try and go for a counter drop here, but that's just a handful of turrets.
What is going on? This, like, half of these medevacs have, like, no health going into this drop to begin with. Oh my god.
You just land the Vikings to get rid of the Marines directly here.
Yeah, I mean, you land the Vikings, they're gonna fight this off. I mean, for Kira, it's kind of like, okay, you don't want the Marines, but surely there was some better way, right?
I mean, maybe he's getting frustrated. Maybe he just feels like it's a little bit too static and he doesn't want to have the game go too long against a guy that's this good at that kind of positional late game TVT. He is freeing up supply for more BCs. I feel like Cure has the BC count advantage, but I can't be too sure. Marpu, can you throw up the units tab real quick? Just have a look here at what we've got.
5-4, 6-6 Ravens.
So Cure's about to have the BC lead once the next round pops out.
It's very close across the board.
So
those five BCs are pretty big, right? That is the big difference, and that's what the supply freeing of the Marines going down did. So TY is kind of in a weird spot where he can't really fight in the sky, but at the same time, Cure can't exactly go and punish him anyways, because any fight where you go across the map, well, you can see it's starting to build up right now. The missile turrets are going to be there in numbers, so...
So Sky, Terran, and Mech on the ground. Both players have thrown away their Marines. Cure still has that one medevac, which is basically the flag bearer for the army. She's not too useful right now.
Yeah, that will not do anything at all. Can lift up, what, tanks?
Yes.
Yeah, SCV drop. A couple bits and pieces of reduce. I mean, missile turret's being lost here, right? They're fighting over no man's land. You know, one guy puts the flag down too far forwards, it gets shot. Was that the medevac?
That was it. She's dead. No. She served her time. One of the few medevacs to survive the great drop of Cure a few minutes ago. But TY is edging forward, still doing more and more damage. It feels like Cure, apart from, he had a BC run by at like 3 o'clock where he did a little bit of SCV damage and played that command center. But he hasn't actually found any actual damage here, really.
Whoa,
oh, he's going to commit now. That's all the turrets can pull back to.
Yeah, the Matrix is nice because you stop it from kind of the BCs from teleporting away. The Vikings just commit into turrets to get a few kills, and I kind of understand why. Those BCs were on their own, if you can call being on top of 20 turrets on their own. But it was good enough still for Cure to go in there, get a few kills, and just drain away a little bit of that TY bank, because at the moment they're both mined off the same amount of bases. This is going to come down to a little bit of an efficiency war in the end. It's now all the turrets dropping down. Of course, that's one hell of an efficient way to trade. Vikings and BCs on the top, though. Yamala's lining up, and Cure gets some shots off.
Certainly does, and there is a big BC advantage for Cure. It feels like his army is a lot better. Both players just blanking each other with anti-armor missiles. All the BCs are Cure here, stacked up, looking for Yamato's Ichimaru with a dead unit. Nice trades for Cure, picking off those Vikings.
What's the resources lost at? Because it does feel like, yeah, Cure is trading way better than TY, 2,500 or so. And again, when you've both already got all the bases, that just means if Cure keeps this up right now, TY's going to run out of money. Or he needs to not let this map mine out and the minerals to mine out. He needs to go and take one big fight, which is nigh on impossible with the defensive setups we've got. I do like this, because these BC should pretty much always get out of here unless they get matrixed.
Yeah, certainly right. So they can tactical jump back. The Ravens are here with the army of Cure as well, though it looks like they might be AWOL. Now, this is interesting from TY, getting drilling claws and throwing in some Widow Mines. This could be a very big gotcha against the superior air army of Cure.
I like it as well, because it stops so much of the movement that Cure would like to do. Right now, BC's going crazy, pushing up that right-hand side, but it gives TY an opening to make some progress on the left. Liberator is sieging up, but the Viking count of Cure is scaring the BC's off for the moment, as this is really Cure making a big play. A base of TY goes down, so many missile turrets as well. Madness on the right side of the map.
Did lose a BC to the turret there, but I absolutely clean up a lot of TY from the right side of the map. Not too many bases actually being mined from here, and TY is starting to get a little bit mineral starved. Sub 400 minerals right now for the Red Terran, with Cure still over 1,000 minerals, but that's starting to dry up too. It's really important to fight over these like external bases that are right on the edge of the map.
This is where Ravens are really good as well, right? Because they're so gas heavy that then, you know, you spend less minerals, you can get better trades perhaps, use up all of your gas, because a lot of the minerals are just going into the masses of static defense, which are the missile turrets, etc. And that's kind of the issue. If all your minerals go into missile turrets and you can't build an army anymore, it's something to keep in mind here throughout the course of the game as it continues to play out, approaching the 25-minute marker, and these guys are not going anywhere.
Yeah, he's got the one tank here on the left side. TY down to two tanks now, with Cure sporting 5. Both players, similar Viking counts, but 18 BCs against 12, and 6 more BCs is such a huge advantage. Yeah. 10 Widow Mines for TY. So he's just going to go to the left-hand side. He's actually committing most of the forces, at least where all of his rich like expensive army is on the left side, letting the right sort of alone for now, not putting too much in there to invest. Same as Widowmine's forward, trying to catch anything, but you don't really want to lose those for free.
Problem is here, right? It's such little investment from Cure because it's just a couple of tanks, really. And that means that you're not investing a huge amount to deny there, so it's not like Cure's out of position on the left side either. One tank here is being attacked by the SDV.
I mean, the SDV will get jobbed down eventually. We'll check on it in a few minutes.
Yeah, set the stopwatch off, see how long it takes. There's a few auto turrets dropping down. Cure getting a little bit afraid. Remember, he doesn't have a lot of those because he's only working on the two Ravens, so he only has about eight or so banked up at a time in comparison to TY. You can drop so many more. Of course, if you're dropping those auto turrets, you lose your utility elsewhere. TY is spending money repairing the command center on the right side, trying to keep that position alive as we continue to fly around the sensor. As the SCV is still doing well there. SCV's getting an idea on the left side. They're going to try and help out on the right unsuccessfully.
Yeah, they're not a great fighting unit, unfortunately. Oh, no!
No,
you're going to get the job done. Feels bad, man. He tried so hard, got so far, but in the end, you know how it goes. Ah, man. I mean, I get a little bit worried for both players here and how the engagement goes. I'm trying to picture it in my head. Seven Ravens means 14 disabled BCs if they all get an interference matrix off.
That's true. I mean, what I'm worried about is how do you cast so many spells in such a short time?
Rapid fire, Woody.
You want a matrix? You want to drop down auto turrets, maybe? It's very, very tough. There's a couple of Neon missiles go down. There goes another Raven off TY. Another expensive unit to replace. Obviously, TY's cut quite a lot of SCVs lately, slash lost them. And that means that his army supply opens up a little bit large. He's, what, seven SCVs behind, so he'll be seven army supply ahead. Again, very minor differences in Widowmine's going off on SCVs here as well. I mean, this is so intense, because one moment where the fight initiates and you're out of position, you're in the wrong spot, and this goes so very wrong for you.
Yeah, absolutely right. That's the thing with his army, is it's so explosive that when they actually do fight, it will end extremely quickly.
Yes. Oh, absolutely.
So much damage
with Widowmine's in there, right? A couple tanks getting in position. He's going to auto turret for the Widowmine's. He kind of knows they're there. He is going to get the auto turret down. He will push these Widowmine's back. When he manages to kill one, which is less than I expected, the Widowmine's might just try and... I mean, they could maybe try and suicide run under the BCs if the BCs are distracted fighting something else at the same time already.
Yeah, these Widowmine's are on the hunt, man. And Cure is really respecting them. Won't let them get anywhere near his stacked up air army. TY is carving himself a bit of a path through the middle of the map here and leapfrogging his tanks forward with the Widowmine's. Yamato here going to pick off one of those tanks.
Widowmine goes off though, as you're going to see an anti-arm missile dropping from the side of QS to TY. Painted orange back in the wave for a moment, still has the Widowmine's to help him zone. Really inserting himself towards the base of Cure here, yet still isn't mining the right side base. So again, he's missing a base that eventually he needs, and that means Cure is mining a lot more right now. Yeah, sure, in the end, Cure's going to mine out faster, but if TY never gets that base back, it's money he'll never have to work with and never be able to build into an army.
Yeah, you're
right. It's just so difficult to choose an engagement here.
In this kind of situation, if the fight happens and it goes really well for TY, could Cure, even with his bank, could potentially be dead. It depends on how the engagement... If they trade, then not really TY won't be the one that can recover. Cure will. He'll be able to get that army back up again.
Exactly, and that's why it's bad for TY, because TY has the pressure on not to just take a fight, but to obliterate Cure's army. He absolutely needs to win so heavily that Cure has no chance to rebuild, and finally he denies this base, but the difference in what's being mined... Hey! Cure's mining TY's base! Don't do... Cure! That's out of control.
Jeez.
So, but, you know, I thought...
What a greedy boy.
I thought these guys had an agreement, you know? That's my side, that's your side. No rush, 45 minutes or so.
I guess not. Turns out we're in a 1v1 war game, Wardy, and there are no friends in StarCraft 2.
Turns out there will be fights happening, okay. I mean, if Cure mines even a little bit from there, right, it's just exemplifying or kind of personifying the point that it is just such a big deal where TY is not mining as much as Cure is, and Cure's bank is so, so high. Yeah, this is... I mean, we just got to wait for the fight and see if TY can make it happen.
It feels like both players have been sitting there, but I've been watching the map, and both players have actually been very, very active with their armies the whole time. These guys are still probably 200, 300 APM, moving units around the map while still, you know, saturating and trying to keep their economies as efficient as possible. It looks slow, but it is fast, and there you go. So TY slowing down a little bit, down to 200. Cure still nearly 400 APM as he floats these army units around.
I mean, because you've got to be so active, right? There's a couple units here, a couple units there, because those are the things that break open these positions. They give you the opportunities to strike, and that's exactly what they're looking for. If you start being lazy and you start dropping down, you sit back, it kind of gives the other guy the chance to get on the map, to take these positions, to take control, to mine more. As TY is just going to give up some of the final SCVs that he has, so he's going to go down to what? 9 workers here, and he's very soon going to be maxed out on almost purely army.
That seems to be the plan here for TY. Secure with 26 SCVs. It feels like Cure is the one that should be throwing away SCVs here because of his bag. TY losing those units does mean he has a big army, but like we've mentioned before, the pressure is on TY to take a really, really good fight. Because if he has anything less, this game will not go his way.
I guess he goes soon, right? He's killed off a few extra SCVs to get a few extra units. He has to force it sometime soon. I mean, yeah, okay, you're going to hit this planchy, you'll take it down, but even the few extra minerals already mined, it makes the difference. A few Matrixes coming down from the side of Cure. He only has 2 Ravens, so now his Ravens pretty low on energy, and maybe that makes it tough for him to do something else. TY gets an insta-kill on the CC there again. As Cure still will not commit into the fight, he will be knocked, be baited forward.
Cure looks like he wants to fight here. He gets another anti-armor missile. The Vikings got a little bit of a shot off there at TY with the tactical jump. Is definitely afraid of that Viking volley. Obviously, the upgrades have been rounded out for both players. 3-3 on all these air units, 3-3 on all the ground units. Or rather, 3-3 on the ground units secure, just +2 attack for TY.
Yeah, actually, missing that mech upgrade might have made a bigger deal, I guess, if there was more tanks earlier. But he did swap into the faster air upgrades, I guess, to try and take an advantage early, and obviously we never really saw that coming through. Another tank sieges out to the left here from TY. Starts to get a shot or two off, nice Matrix, and that will be a bit of a fight. We don't mind trying to get in position. I mean, it's crazy, right? Just these little fights happening. 6,000 resource loss difference. Cure with 5k more minerals, 6k more gas in the bank. I mean, just ridiculous number, 7k more gas in the bank even. Trying to do math, I mean, after a game like this, it's not easy.
Yeah. I mean, it'd be cool to break this replay down and just spend 3 hours combing it through with all you analysts out there, but we still have the job to do, as it looks like the fight might be kicking in. Anti-armor missile on the BCs there for both players. TY trying to split his units, but they both eat quite a bit of damage there. Or rather, they eat quite a bit of the debuff there. Still 10 Ravens for TY, so if Cure commits, he has to be extremely careful.
Yeah, this is what it comes down to. TY knows he has to fight sooner rather than later. He can't build up any more army. He's already thrown away so many SCVs. A couple of models being traded, but it is Cure getting all of the initial hits here. As TY will take down a base. I mean, he's positioned himself in an awkward, interesting spot. And now we'll see if he can get out of it and make something happen. Because, yeah, the BCs can teleport out. His Vikings and Ravens can't, though.
I think TY is deliberately letting these SCVs live as well, because he doesn't want Cure to have more armor supply.
I mean, it's true, right? You know, you give up, you let him kill, you know, you kill 12 SCVs and suddenly he can build 2 more BCs. You don't want that.
Exactly.
You want him to have useless SCVs fighting a missile turret in the middle of the map. As this fight continues down the bottom side.
Those command centers are getting deleted!
Were they even in the game? What do they make these out of nowadays? Paper?
Oh man, origami command centers. I didn't know that skin was in the game. Anti-armor there and a cluster of BCs. Decent splits from TY. Ooh, that's a big chunk of BCs.
Yeah,
I think TY wants the fight.
Yeah, absolutely. He's going to start going for your model. What's going on? It's the third Matrix is everywhere as this is it, Maynard.
I think TY is actually winning this fight. Dude, it's actually so close though. The BCs of Cure, so many of them got locked down. TY's army supply and Cure is still similar, but it's actually so crazy. A lot of Cure's army supply is in production. It's 10 BCs against 3. It's 4 BCs and 8 Vikings on the way. And Thor's TY's fight, the fight he wanted, I think he just got it.
I think he got it, but you know what? He has to keep going right now. If he doesn't end this game, Cure is going to rebuild, and that is going to become the issue. Cure has spent all of his money. He had 8,000 minerals that have just gone, and as you can see right now, TY jumps in. Cure is trying to fight, jumps the Vikings back up. More coming in. He's building Marines!
That's not going to help him out too much against these 3-3 BCs. They are so damaged, though, and the turrets are softening him up. TY just parking on top of this production here. Cure kind of smacked back here. Mass mule from TY. Not for manners, for repairs. Don't get too excited. He wants these BCs to be healthy as he sits on top of that production. Anything that pops out is going to be hit by the BCs. The Thor's anti-air is actually so sick here from Cure.
The Thor's are killing so freaking much. More BCs though, reinforcing in. Here comes Cure coming in from the top side as well. Yamada can't start dropping down once again. And TY supply is dropping. The Vikings come back in the skies. The Thor's are dead. BC after BC drops, however, and it looks as though Cure might just about hold on. He will. GG.
Unbelievable. Man, that game went for 27 minutes, and then they just decided to draw. Yeah. My God, did that game go to 11 real quick?
Wow.
Holy crap.
Woo! Take a breather.
Yeah. Oh, God.